Hello and welcome to the non-Greg Stirless Greg Stirless show. Except only the substitutes. I am your host, the Pamazon. Well, this is a much better angle for me over here. What's up with that? yes, and we have some guests today. Let's see who we got. Oh, it's the Jonazon as usual. And he's got the Penelope.
I'm looking like the Iron Sheik with this huge double chin and this mustache.
John got an unfortunate
I'm about
trim.
To like make you humble, as the Iron Sheik always says.
Hi, friends.
Dudley, what'd you say, Dudley?
Hello.
Hello, Dudley.
Dudley.
Hey, we got Tony.
What's going on?
Make sure you're speaking to your microphone.
Hey, what's going on?
There you go. And Sam.
Oh, hi.
Hi, Pamazon.
Hey, Sam.
It's back to be good.
Oh, Sam. Yeah. I'm glad to see you. And then we got our musical guest, hey, Bobby Angel.
Hello, everybody.
Buffalo's on, Bobby Angel.
So great to be here. Thanks for having me.
You are welcome.
I'm having a blast already.
Yay.
All right.
Bobby Angel, I gave Bobby Angel my gluten-free beer, which wasn't really gluten-free. It was just gluten-reduced, so it made me very ill.
Gluten-reduced, yeah, there's such a thing. Well, now...
Now we know. Yeah, don't do it. Don't do it. Gluten reduce does not cut it. People who cannot
it's a scam.
It's a scam.
I just so many scams. Beer.
Well, you can drink beer. I can drink Guinness, which is good.
Oh, yeah.
It's made with oats, so not wheat.
Yeah.
Oh, what?
I didn't know that. It's like having a sundae, I always.
Yes.
And the little one drinks that as well?
No. he's only six. He's too young.
I tried, but he gave me a simple special soda once. I didn't like it, though. It's bitter.
To reduce any chances of someone finding out which one it was, I'm going to say one of my nieces or nephews, back when I could drink any beer before I had Lyme disease, I had dark beer. Like, I love it. It's dark as you get, it tastes like you should put on your damn pancakes. And I drank a bunch of it, right? And my little niece and her nephew, who was only like two, I put the bottle down. There's only a tiny drip of backwash.
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, no. And they're like, yum.
This is the moment where they'll either become an alcoholic or swear off alcohol for life, right?
I mean, it was the most bitter, dark beer. I could not believe they liked it, but they also used to steal all the kombuchas out of the fridge when they were little.
Really? See? That's a strong tasting drink.
I know, for a little kid, yes. Yes, for a little kid, it was a very odd drink. It's true.
It's a kombucha.
It's like a what?
What's a kombucha?
It's pretty good.
It's like fermented tea.
Fermented tea.
Yeah, it's not alcoholic.
Unlike it's vinegar.
Yeah, it tastes a lot like vinegar. It's got a very vinegary aftertaste. And we could only get John's favorite flavor.
They don't even make this brand anymore.
And he would be so excited to get it. And then my little nephew would get in there and drink. Oh. Or niece would drink them all.
Oh, no.
It's all right. I've got several nephews.
I had this elderflower and honey one or something from Tops a while back. That was
pretty good.
That sounds good. Purple bottle. Yeah.
Yes, I know that one. I want that.
It was delicious.
John wants it right now.
Yes.
I like the watermelon one.
Wait, I haven't tried that.
Oh, do you like watermelon a lot?
I love watermelon.
Me too. It's like the cotton candy of fruits.
I like those mushroom ones. Mushroom root beer and Coca-Cola ones are cool.
What do you like, Sammy?
Mushrooms.
Oh, there you go. There's mushroom kombucha.
Yeah, that's one he got hold of pretty fucking hard.
How about you, Dudley? Do you like mushrooms?
The magic 102.5 variety.
Of mushrooms?
The 102.5 variety, huh?
Yes, of shroomies.
You got some tunes for us?
Wait, no, we're still going to talk.
Oh, sorry. You don't yet. I'm sorry.
Hi, John. You jumping? You jumping something? I don't know.
Jumping the gun?
Jumping the gun, yes.
Yeah. I thought you were going to say jumping the fire.
I was going to say jumping the shark, but that's a TV phrase.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what Woody Woodpecker, not Woody Woodpecker, the fox jumping the shark.
Oh, I haven't heard this before.
Oh, you ever heard it?
No.
So that was supposedly when Happy Days got really desperate. It was when the Fonz had to motor... Like, no way.
He had to roller skate. He had to, like... jet ski over a shark.
It wasn't jet skiing, though, right? Wasn't
not really jet skiing, but, you know, yeah.
Like water skiing,
yeah,
right?
Water skiing.
Over a shark.
Oh,
yeah, that was supposedly when they were like, all right,
they're desperate, yeah. Oh. That's a phrase for when TV shows reach peak desperation and go downhill.
Oh, my God.
No.
We haven't hit that yet, right? No,
I don't know, maybe.
I thought it would have to do something with Shark Tank and, like, you jump this shark. Like, you showed that... What do you know?
Our TV show has actually been has several hosts in several locations.
Oh,
so,
really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So you're doing great. And you're still kicking.
How long has it been? How long has it been, Dudley? How long have we been going since 90?
29 years.
29 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
So
29.
It's basically almost the same age as me, really.
Wow.
Yeah, well, it's a couple years.
Just a couple years on it, but I mean, I'd be like a toddler. So that's the thing.
That's wild.
Yeah.
Right? That's why I say the non-Greg Strohless Greg Strohless show, because Greg Strohless started it in what year? What year, Dudley?
94.
Oh, wow. I must have been a guest from kind of the beginning then. Because when I met Greg, I hadn't been in Buffalo a super long time, and I didn't really know him. He was just a page at the library. He's like, come on my TV show. I was like, okay.
Wow. Being a guest on Pat Your Head.
Yeah.
What'd you say, Tony?
I remember being a guest on Pat Your Head.
Yes, that was my other TV show that I had. It was totally totally music. That your episode is online.
Oh, no.
Unlike some of them, which are, I don't know if they're lost, but they are. Some of them are lost because the audio didn't transfer. And some of them are lost because they're on these big, awkward tapes that I have no way to transfer. What kind of tapes is that, Dudley?
U-matic.
U-matic tapes, yes. And at work, they had a U-matic tape player, and they did exactly one tape, of which I already had digitized. I was like, oh. And then the U-matic player broke. So... And that's why you saw, Dudley, when you visited my work, that's why you saw those U-matic tapes in the hallway, because they used to use those for...
Yeah, I'll take them back in time and transfer them for you.
That would be awesome.
Very cool.
Yeah, yeah. U-matic tapes are these big, giant, thick tapes that were, like, for broadcast. So, yeah.
We've been around long enough, we're bigger now than Jimmy Buffett. Yeah, I'll tell you what, though. I hope
Jimmy Buffet.
Why about this decide to give Captain Cook in a barrel at sea? Oh, hurricane!
I was
back in no time.
I always confuse Jimmy Buffett and Warren Buffett. I never know which one is which.
Yeah.
Oh, right. Well,
I really don't. It's like how I always confuse Stevie Nicks and Nikki Sixx.
That's
so many similarities.
Just a little bit dyslexic.
I can never tell which one is which. I always forget.
Well, that's easy.
Well,
Jimmy's the one that bit the
dirt. 80s hair, and, you know, it goes from there.
Yeah, they both, that's true. 80s hair for both.
No, Jimmy Buffett didn't have any hair at the end.
I was very surprised by when he died, how many people were very, like, oh my God, blah, blah, blah. I was very surprised that he had as many big fans. I hated that. I didn't like his songs, so I was surprised. I don't know.
You know,
were you a fan? You said you were a fan.
At one time, I liked his music, but in the last 6 years, when everything pretty much started going down the shitter at a rapid clip, his music kind of became annoying, and I tuned in more to Gordon Lightfoot. Who, by the way, in case anyone didn't know, died the same fucking year as Buffett, only this past May. Actually, he wrote songs about and for the Working Man, but no! You wouldn't know about that, would you out there, Jimmy?
Yeah. What's his famous song? I always get confused. I always think he
wrote
the
Edmund Fitzgerald.
No, not that guy. That not. Oh. Yeah, no, I know.
Warren Buffett?
No, yeah. I always think he wrote that horrible Pina Colada song, but
no,
he
that's
didn't.
Not him.
Oh,
no,
yeah.
That's that Rupert Holmes.
Oh, you're thinking of Margaritaville.
Margaritaville, yeah.
Wasting away.
Getting the Margaritaville.
That song's way better than the Pina Colada song.
The Pina Colada song is worse. I will give Jimmy Buffett the head.
Oh,
if you like Pina Coladas.
Oh, that crap. Yeah, but he didn't write that much, too.
Rupert Holmes. Trying to get me and Andy to do that at that one.
Rupert Holmes wrote that, yeah.
Okay.
That Paul Rubens wrote so, that?
Huh?
Paul Rubens wrote
no.
that?
I think so.
Oh.
Yeah, he did, absolutely.
I really thought that's what you
God
said.
Damn
I was
it,
like, what?
Pee-wee.
I mean, I like Pee-wee. But...
That's everything.
Charity. Yeah. How do you do the? I can't really even tell.
Oh, laughing but... hurts my shoulder. Right, it real.
I used to love that show, though.
Yeah, the show is great.
Yeah.
My mother's name was Marge. So we were watching the movie, and then when Large Marge came on.
Oh, yeah.
My
Marge.
Poor mother.
I love the movie, but I don't like the circus movie.
We're like,
movie.
Marge, get in here. And she was like, what? And we like rewind it because it was VHS, you know. And she's like, my poor mom.
Marge.
There yes. was Large Marge is one of the best so. Characters.
And then like kind of sort of brother, so really seven. So she had to hear seven kids howling and laughter.
I wish there was more.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So
we had seven, too.
Herman actually wrote Pina Coladas?
Yeah,
the Pina Colada song is Rupert Holmes.
Rupert
Holmes. And he looks as cheesy as his song. I gotta say that.
Is he related to John Holmes?
I don't know. That's
you
a
know
good
about
question.
John Holmes?
And that was about him joining a dating website or putting mm-hmm. a dating ad out, right?
Wasn't a wouldn't have been a website because it was the 70s.
No
yeah, it would have been.
Yeah, yeah, that's true.
Like probably a newspaper.
Or
yeah,
or he read it.
Yeah, probably
it's like
the
a newspaper
thing.
Personal, I think.
Yeah, newspaper personal, and then he puts it in to cheat on his girlfriend, and then she shows up. And they're like, ha ha, isn't it cute? We're trying to like fuck other people, and
well,
we didn't have any agreements in place to do so. So yeah, it just seemed very. I hated that song. One song I do like, a lot of people don't like, is Baker Street.
I'm not sure of that one.
Oh, yeah.
That song's good. People don't get enough credit.
Everybody's like, it's Yacht Rock. I'm like, Yacht Rock?
Yacht Rock.
A
yes.
song about a dude drinking himself to death is Yacht Rock? I mean, that seems pretty fucking dark. And then he actually did... I think it's Jerry Rafferty, and then he actually did drink himself to death.
Oh,
I
no.
mean, he wasn't
what
just saying
what do you
it.
Do on a yacht after you have all your bills paid?
I
on
drink
yacht
yourself to death.
Drink yourself to death. I don't know.
On your way down Baker
yeah.
Street. Da-da-da-da-da, oh, yeah. Light on your feet, another something-something, da-da-da-da, and forget about everything. Does that ring any bells? You,
no,
if you heard it, you would know it.
I think you would know. That song is so...
It's ubiquitous.
I know.
Ingrained. It's like, if you haven't even heard it through, like, cultural osmosis, I would be surprised. It's such a...
We might be doing it a disservice since we don't know any of the lyrics or anything, and we're only mimicking the sax solo.
I know, I thought I was trying to pick out a melody, but it was tough on me.
Yeah.
And you all were on note there, so.
Yeah, it is the sax solo.
Now I'm going to have to look it up.
Yeah. He was also here. In Steeler's Wheel. Jerry Rafferty, I believe, right?
I don't know.
Stuck in the middle with you. Stuck in the
oh,
middle
yeah.
with you. Yeah, that he was also in that
Billy
band previously.
Sounds
yeah. believe, unless I'm remembering wrong, but I think I remembered correct.
Hey, Peppy, how's it going?
But yeah. And, yeah.
To the Google machine.
To the Google machine! To the Google machine! Did you ever watch Mighty Boosh?
What?
Mighty Boosh.
It's like a British
it's
show.
It's so good.
No.
Sorry,
it's
it
really
was just
good.
Reminding me of that for a second. I don't know why.
What the hell is Mighty Boosh?
Oh, it's so good. I mean, we talked about it before in here, but if you haven't watched it,
yeah, that sounds
you should watch it.
Pretty cool.
God damn you.
Yeah.
I'm saying
like B O S C H B O S
B O O S H yeah.
Yes, he was in
no, you don't have to watch it. I'm sorry.
According to the Wikipedia, the free encyclopedia.
I was correct. No, it's okay. Maybe it's not your type of humor. But damn, is it funny? So funny, yeah. It's really funny.
Just Mighty Boosh or
Mighty Mighty. Well, if you type in Mighty Boosh, there'll be a ton of things that come up on YouTube.
I think it is the Mighty Boosh, but you could probably just type in
the Mighty Boosh.
I don't even really know what that means, but I've watched the whole show.
So the wizard guy that his hair was really puffy, and somebody said that's they were trying to say it's a Mighty Bush, but they had an accent and they said that's a Mighty Boosh.
Oh.
And so they named the show The Mighty Boosh.
What is that? It sounds Canadian. So what is...
It's from England.
Even though English people get really mad if you call them European.
Although, yeah, there was definitely lots of fun sketch SCTV. Did anybody watch SCTV?
Oh, yes.
No? No?
No.
SCTV is
Boys in the Hall, right? That's also Canadian.
Kids
in the Hall. Sorry. Yeah. God damn it.
But you just watched it for the boys in the hall.
I did. God damn it.
You know, posters up.
That's pretty cool.
But they were always in drag, so.
They were. It's true. They were. They were often in drag. Yeah, so. Yeah. The Mighty Boosh. So how long do you want to play?
We got
15 minutes or 10 minutes?
Oh.
Because we've got around 14 minutes left.
No, remember it's a... Oh, yeah, now 14.
Oh.
Do you want to go now? Do you want to wait a couple minutes?
Sure.
Okay, you want to go now?
I'm ready.
All right, he's ready. Clap!
My cover of I Dream a Highway by Gillian Welles. Johnny's kicking out the footlights. Lord, let me die with the hammer in my hand. I dream of highway back to you. Think I'll move to Memphis and thank the hatchet man who forked my tongue. Thank you. winding ribbon with a band of gold. A silvery vision, come arrest my soul. I dream of my way back to you. I dream of my way back to you.
Here's an original I wrote called The Whispering Pines. Don't you put your little hand in mine. You're all the good music is. You dance just like little kids. Wandering from shore to shore, this thirsty boy needs another more. He's warm and misty air, wine and water everywhere. You and you and you. Mystical, magical love can be tragical. What am I to do? Born of earth, sky, and storm. Don't you look to the whispering pines? Why don't you put your little hand in mine? We all these kids, we dance just like little kids. Everybody's trying to swim into heaven. I'm on the boat they call prayer. Some folks have found the sacrifice. I'll get you halfway there. Melody makes heaven complete. What comes next, you got to kiss me, baby. Life is just a merry-go-round. What you do is sit look to the whispering pines. Why don't you put your little hand in mine? We're all the good music is. We dance just like little kids. We're all the good music is. We dance just like little kids. Oh, you very much. I'll do one more, part of one more, called Stars in the Night Sky that I wrote some years back and I dug out to perform tonight. We'll see how it goes. Thank you. Uh-oh. And I haven't killed any dogs or anything. It's no good for you. It was very good for me. I'm all rain on the treetops, rain on the leaves. You're my rock, goodbye, baby. I know it's shining star, way beyond the caravan, very, very far. Do you ever listen to the sound? Strumming in the flash of the neon light. Goodbye, stars in the night sky. This is my high time. Stars in the night sky. Feel like a dream storm. You thought nothing could bring me back again. By the bread in the saints of the world, and I was laughing. Everybody.